here, and the perspective that I'd like to share at this occasion is actually my experience as a teacher educator at the University of Vienna, as an individual who's been trying to champion the cause of global education and development education over a number of years in an academic setting. And probably those of you who've been in this field, you know what it takes. Not only to make it, to offer a global education course in the teacher education program, but to sustain over years, in spite of many other agenda, which are pushing and to keep it a part of the curriculum. So what I'm going to share with you is something that has that is a process that actually is a result of practice, is a result of experience. It fits perfectly with what Andy has been saying. So it's actually working on that and translating that into teacher education. Kind of asking, okay, well, what kind of teachers do we need who would pass on these ideas to students? And then again, as teacher educators, asking ourselves, asking those of us who are dealing with teachers and who are involved in teacher education, how do we create spaces within academic settings of university courses, of higher education courses, that provide a space where you can engage with the global enterprise at a personal, at the same time, pedagogically relevant manner? And here I'd like to stress both. The pedagogical relevance is extremely important. It's all that was talking about, of the skills, of the knowledge, of the attitudes that need to be passed on to the generations so that the heritage that they've received from the world, that they are enabled, empowered to change it, to carry it forward. The experience that I've made as a teacher educator is that in the academic setting of seminars, of courses, of lecture at the university, you can achieve that at the level, and that's where I tie in with the affective and the cognitive level that Andy was talking about. You can pass on this information at a cognitive level. And you could engage probably your students at, not all of them, but those who develop an action, at a certain level. What was missing for me the whole time was making the global a personal concern. It was running into the obstacle of global education courses end up being another course out there too. I need the credits, so I'll be there. I need the final mark, so I'll actually reproduce what I know the instructor wants to hear from me. And that's where you start asking, well, how do you keep this? How do you turn this into something which is meaningful to the individuals? Not only professionally, not only as professional teachers, not only, okay, the kind of knowledge that I need, that I'm a professional, but what does this mean to me as a person? So my work has been very much in that creating that connection, that relevance. And I realized that what it needs in these spaces that we work as teacher educators, we need to renegotiate rules, roles, positions, and fixed identities. We go into these spaces as teacher educators with defined roles as who I am and what kind of knowledge I have here, as a seasoned teacher educator, to pass on to the new generation of teachers. And we have the fixed roles of teacher trainees sitting there, which is, I might call passive, instead of proactive, and distance and detached rather than personally relevant. So I think at the core of the concern, at the core is the concern that what we need to do is to be able to shake off the lethargy the disinterest and the short-sightedness that is imposed on us by society. And that doesn't affect only the society out there. It affects the teachers we try to educate. And that was kind of the agenda that I've been trying to push through. And then I've been looking for a language to pass this on. How do I articulate this? And I needed methods to renegotiate our roles in the seminar space. Kind of renegotiate the roles of, okay, as students, more or less, we're socialized in terms of, I reproduce what is appropriate here. You know, I either sit back and listen and, you know, pass on assignments, or if dealing in, you know, if we're in a discussion or if we're doing a presentation, I would more or less reproduce what I read on the internet about human rights education and development education. I would reproduce what is necessary to get my marks and to go through. But how do I disable that? How do we renegotiate those relationships which have become accustomed, typical to university courses? And there I've been looking for methodologies, and one method that has been useful, and I must confess I haven't really been religiously, fanatically, I've been drawing on elements which are useful and which have proven to be helpful, and that is the methodology that I would be introducing this afternoon, along with other experiences that both of us have in creating and negotiating those spaces. I got the 3 minutes post site, and I think I'm pretty much done with what I wanted to relate initially. I'll come to the question that I would like to pose. So the question is, how do you create spaces in higher education, specifically in teacher education, when we're talking about teachers for age, for change, you know, how do you pass this on to teachers in service, pre-service, where participants are invited to look at their own experience, at their own position, within these courses, within schools, within society, and their own envisaged professional role as teachers. You know, to what extent do we see our role as agents of change, yes or no? How do you create those spaces? Why do you tackle issues of global import in a crisis-laden world? So how do you delve into those critical issues of right now, you know, the mass migration which we're experiencing. How do you go in there? And how do you make it personally relevant, pedagogically relevant? And how can you translate it in terms of what does this mean for me